Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today I have some more tech-savvy content for you.
So you have this FrSky X9 Lite S and you finally decide to go with ELRS. You still have some FrSky original receivers, so you want to keep the internal module and don't want to switch to an only ELRS transmitter. So I think you have an additional module bay. Let's go for that. You get rid of the covering and then you see there is a bay for a nano module and you think, let's go with a state-of-the-art module from Radiomaster. This also has the nano bay in the back and you think you can simply pop it in there and go for it. Turns out that these sidewalls are way too large and that's why the nano module, which has far shorter sidewalls, so this thickness, and the pins cannot reach their counterparts. If you slide it in, it's way too thick. Somehow you have to come up with an idea how to do this. But you might also notice that the module barely fits below the handle here, which is also kind of a mess. If you compared it to a standard Radiomaster Zorro, you can see that there are almost no sidewalls and the module easily slides in here. So no issues with that. But we are quite lucky because Radiomaster has made a very solid casing for this module. And what you see here at the back, this is just the pin board taken out from the Radiomaster Ranger module. So if you get open these four screws to the side, you see this is the ribbon cable and this easily goes through this opening where the pin board was originally coming out. You just get the cable through, put the screws back in, and then you slide in the ribbon cable there, and you have the adapter connected. And this adapter perfectly fits into the FrSky X9 Lite S. I'll show you in a minute where to get this from and how to adapt the original SDR file.
So this is the file you can find on Thingiverse, FrSky X9 Lite adapter for TBS crossfire micro module. You can see here's the part for the nano bay and this is the extension for the micro module. If you have a look at the pictures attached, it's quite a bulky piece, but it fits nicely into this nano module bay and this part is actually what we gonna need. So somehow we get rid of this bigger part, just print the upper section, and then we're gonna use this for our nano module from Radiomaster to attach it to the FrSky X9 Lite. I'm here in my slicing software, which is Ultimate Cura, but I guess this trick is working every normal slicing software. I'm gonna import the STL file that I have downloaded from Thingiverse. This is positioned perfectly. The whole object stands on this back edge, but this gives me the opportunity to cut the whole object in this horizontal pane. And you can achieve this quite easily. Just select, push it through the build plate, slice the object, control in the preview. You see there are no layers printed below the printing surface. This is how I got the right part of the adapter for the Radiomaster nano module that perfectly fits into the X9 Lite. I have printed this module with standard PETG with three top layers, which is quite important for this mounting screw, which you take out of the Radiomaster module. The screw holds the pin board in place when pushing the module into the bay. This is how I got my gear working with the ELRS module from Radiomaster, without any construction efforts. Well guys, thanks for watching. If you dig content like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.